past. Okay? How do we recover the lost identity through these acts of fighting? Okay? The criticism has always been what one is to pay attention to these deeds of righteousness or fighting is really about hypocrisy. Look at this bridge. Whenever you give alms, you don't sound like that. Image, sabi, di ba? Images, images. Sounding a trumpet or a trumpet. Announcement, announcement, announcement. Agora, so what is the contract position? How do you make so that this act will not be about hypocrisy? Secret.
In secret. In your room.
Don't let your left know what the right is doing. Pray to the room, lock the door. I hope you're getting the images now. But we try as much as that. So these righteous, but take note that the premise here is these righteous deeds are means to recover the lost identity. Cannot be used for the false protection, self-recognition, use for super story or creation, or self-proclamation. Okay? That is, otherwise, it falls to impulse. No. No.
The paradigm there is.
It is.
Secret. Secret. I'm sorry. On the plane, go to your room, shut the door, pray for the Father who is in
secret.
On fasting. Put the oil in your head, wash your face, let your fasting be received. Not the others. The Father who is in
secret.
Let's try to. How do you mean? Let's go to that close prayer.
Yes,
You have Father, who sometimes remember that he is. Father begins with our Father, the one in the heavens. The one in the heavens. If you look into the first part, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done. Okay? Then you have on earth as it is in heaven. Think of this, a very interesting one. This is a very interesting on earth as it is in heaven. Number one is an imperative. After the moon, morning toys or noise, happy is also the masses. This third imperative. In other words, the one praying is commanding his Father, happy is tato to or maso, let your name be made holy on earth as it is in heaven. Kasi yung pangalat as it is in heaven, ang nasing inibigay natin sa dulo, is actually, it has a threefold function for every Habi es teto to onomaso. El teto hei basileso. Your kingdom, el teto let it enter. Let it happen. Let it enter. Because actually in the beginning he said, the kingdom of God is at hand. The problematic statement of you after the baptism, he appeared and said, the kingdom of God. What is the kingdom? It says, let it happen. Let it enter. Oh, it's already on earth as it is in heaven. Jesus' prayer. Now, you know, let us get to Jesus' prayer. Let us get to Jesus' prayer.
dramatic statement in the scripture.
Early morning. People, the disciples, before the rest of the disciples are up. They will go to a service place on his own and pray. What is that, this prayer? Because this prayer talks about his mission. Your will and the king of the earth is in his hand. But this is a mission that is a shared mission between the Father and the Son. Well, your name, let it be your kingdom. This is on earth as it is. And it's already in heaven, let it happen. Thank God that this is a prayer that we share. We share to the disciples. Yeah. So we who are now praying that prayer, what is it we said there is, we are now supposed to participate and share in that. Read that within the context of go to the room, shut the door, and pray to the Father. Would it be that the secret here is our role in sharing in that prayer is to share in that same prayer and pushing it so that our prayers now do not become for show. It's a sharing. You pray this prayer. You do this act of fasting. You do this act of almsgiving because you want to make the earth as it is in heaven. You participate this time in the prayer, in the shared mission. Notice that there is then the absence of hypocrisy. Who knows? So that the Catholics are planning. Catholics are having a secret. And I think the connection is very, very strong. Participate in the shared mission. To make this verse as it is in heaven. Remember that this is within the junction of the new pregnancy. Multiple words, you know, as I do. Just like this. They think that, God, no one knows who is that. Your Father knows. But as they have nothing to give. Yes, this is how. I realize that the prayer is Jesus' mission to live the Father. Your will, let it be on earth. Your kingdom, let it happen. I will talk about what is the kingdom later on. There is still your kingdom in chapter 4. The picture of the kingdom is chapter 4 of Mark, the kingdom of God is like, it starts with the parable of the sower. That really is not a parable of the sower. It's not a parable of the soil. There are four types of soil. Diba? The path, rocky, turning ground, but there is only one ground that makes the seed grow. Then the Lord comes in and interprets that after all, the soil is not the soil, it's not only it's about a soul. So there's only one type of soul that could make the seed grow, the words grow. Then the next parable comes in and says, how does the seed grow? It's a mysterious way. Right? The sower comes in, he sows, he goes to sleep, then he goes to bed, but it is the ground, the earth, that in a mysteriously, in a mysterious way, makes the seed grow. But he has already talked about the ground as the soul. Right? If I look,
good.
When you talk about the kingdom of God, yes, the kingdom of God is light. Right? Kingdom of God is light. So after all, the kingdom of God is really not about the ground, not about the place somewhere else. Because at the very beginning, it says the kingdom of God is at hand. How do you make it realize? Repent and believe. So he talks about the kingdom of God, it's not about our place. He's talking about us, probably four types of soil, four types of soul, but there is only one type of soul that is capable of repenting and believing. The last parable there is that seed, like a mustard seed, smallest was it, okay? Biggest was from that is the bird's voice. The paradigm is repent. Repent, metanoia is a change of paradigm. Metanoia is change of mind. So, can we go back? Go. What is that alternative? Believe the gospel. That is the paradigm of making the kingdom. You notice, you parallel beatitudes, the kingdom of God. Look at the chapter 4. That's about the kingdom of God. That's why in that interesting is blessed are the meek, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. Chapter 4 Mark, chapter 12 Mark, it talks about that. It's about the soul capable of resolving. It begins with the soil. So go back to the beatitudes. That's why towards chapter 5 of that book, you know, seek first the kingdom of heaven and its righteousness. Hopefully that we make the millennial and the Bible. It's image race, look at the image race. Okay. If you have sharing, if you have reflections, there are questions. I will go to the third metaphor. I still have two materials. One, the child, the little guy. The other is, I actually have written another bullet. The child in Matthew. Third metaphor of the child. The child in Matthew is indeed the best description of it. The child there is not actually a child. He's the greatest in the kingdom of heaven, in that sense. Otherwise, power dies.